If you have been using Linux every day on your personal computer for a while, you reach a point where things feel comfortable. You know how to install a distro, you're not scared of the terminal anymore. You may not remember every command out there, but you know how to figure out things. You understand package managers, desktop environments, and probably basic troubleshooting. And then this question hits you, what next? In this video, I'll share 5 things Linux users should try in 2026 to level up. Actually, these are mostly based on my New Year resolutions, and not all of these will be applicable to you, but you will surely find one or two to add to your New Year resolution as a desktop Linux user. First resolution, start a home lab, even a small one. The single biggest upgrade you can give yourself as a desktop Linux user is running Linux as a server. I'm not talking about a rack or enterprise hardware, a spare laptop, an old PC, or a small single board computer like Raspberry Pi is more than enough, for the beginning of course. Set it up as a media server, a photo backup system, a personal cloud, an ebook server, or even a small self-hosted dashboard. To make things easier in the beginning, use a distro like UnoHost or projects like CasaOS or UmbrellaOS that let you easily deploy various services in just a click, minimal configuration needed. Now, why a home lab matters? Well, the first obvious benefit is the control over your own data. But there is more. You start thinking about Linux in terms of services, uptime, storage, networking. You won't easily explore these things as a regular home user. So now Linux turns into a new playground. Actually, I am starting a new YouTube channel called Casual Home Labber, where I'll be sharing how I'm setting up my home lab as a beginner. Hopefully, it will help you learn a few things as well. Second resolution, learn Docker, even just the basics. Home lab operating systems are great for starting, but sooner or later, you will hit a limitation. This is where Docker comes in. After all those home lab operating systems run Docker underneath. You don't need to become a Docker expert. Not that you cannot become one, but you don't need it. You should know the absolute basics, like what a container is, what Docker images are, what is a Docker volume, how Docker Compose works, etc. Just the basics. Here is a real example why you should be doing this. I was using Jima board with Jima OS. The Jellyfin server deployed from Jima's app store could not use the GPU and was taking 100% of CPU while transcoding 4K media. So after going through forums and suggestions, I edited the Docker Compose file and fixed the issue all my own. That's the power of Docker knowledge. Once you understand Docker, you are no longer locked into CasaOS or Umbrel. You can deploy self-hosted software on any Linux distro. Bottom line, Docker is still a recommended skill for Linux users in 2026. Third resolution, build a Linux-powered smart home. Smart devices are cheaper and more common than ever. Most people go with Amazon Alexa and Google Home. That is comfortable, but you never know how your data is being misused by them. As a Linux user, you have an alternative in the form of Home Assistant. With Home Assistant, your data stays local. Automations run even without internet, and different brands could work together from a single app. Now, don't go all in for a smart home. Start small. Experiment with smart plugs, motion sensor, or inexpensive smart bulbs. Do keep in mind to buy devices that are compatible with Home Assistant. Check the official website or ask in the forum if you have doubt. In my case, I have these Tapo or TP-Link smart devices that work well with Home Assistant. Well, the smart home automation will help you explore networking basics, service integrations, and APIs and automation logic. More than anything, it's incredibly satisfying when you take control of your smart home, just as you take control of your system, your computer with Linux. Fourth resolution, go deeper with kernels and system performance. Most desktop Linux users never touch the kernel, and that's fine. But if you want to understand Linux deeply, try kernel-level experiments. You know, try compiling a kernel yourself, installing a custom kernel, benchmarking before and after, those kind of things. I advise doing this on a spare system rather than making your main system your testing ground. You can try Licorice kernel and other low latency or performance focused kernels for this purpose. Compare their boot times, responsiveness, gaming or workload performance, etc. You will start to understand what those kernel flags and schedulers and other stuff actually do and what they mean. This is a learning opportunity. Fifth resolution, learn system level programming or EBPF. If you want to reach the core of Linux, you have to go lower. I suggest either system programming or EBPF. EBPF is relatively new and trending these days. It lets you observe and interact with Linux kernel without modifying it. This is used for performance analysis, networking, and system monitoring. Now, system programming, on the other hand, is evergreen. It teaches you how Linux actually works under the hood. Processes, memory, syscalls, you know, all those things you might have come across in the passing. Even basic exposure will transform how you think about, you know, a slow Linux system or bugs and issues. And the sixth resolution is to try an immutable Linux distro. Sixth, yes, I added an extra for people who want to stay in the comfort of desktop Linux. Well, you can still challenge yourself by trying an immutable distro like NixOS. Now, NixOS is not for everyone as you have a steep learning curve here, but it could be a good challenge for you in 2026. We have a NixOS starter series on our website, itsfirst.com, and it was written 2 years ago, but it should still help you out. Well, if you have already crossed the Linux beginner stage, the next step is building, breaking, fixing, and understanding. Again, these are just suggestions. See what suits your interest and how much free time you have. Start small. See what you already have. Don't start splurging money on devices, gadgets, disks, RAMs. You know, now I want to know what resolution you have as a Linux user, what you want to do in 2026. Do leave it in the comments. If you enjoy Linux content like this, you already know where to find more. It's FOSS. I'll see you in the next one.